I read the book and I thought it was like just one of the most incredible pieces of writing, because it's something that everybody can relate to. You know, everybody has some aspect of this in their family, you know, whether one or both of the parents, the siblings, the children, you know, all of it. For some reason, a lot of people seem to relate to it, and I was no exception. I just felt like it was great writing and very powerful. Then I got really psyched when Destin was involved, and then, of course, when Bree was involved, who's an old friend of mine, or I guess a young friend of mine. I'm an old friend of hers, and so I was very excited to be part of this. This book was written by Jeanette Walls, and Rex Walls is her father. And part of the fascinating and complex story is that her father was a very loving guy, but he was also had a lot of problems. He was an alcoholic. He was he would do really questionable things as a parent. He didn't necessarily believe in traditional schooling, and you know, there was just a lot about him that made her growing up difficult, but also made it singular. And as well as, you know, with her mother, Rosemary. But, you know, really interesting guy. Not perfect by any means. I think there's a lot about Rex, which people don't generally, or his own family didn't even know, which was that he was, for example, he took a exam to get into the Air Force, and the the higher up didn't believe that it was a real, that he had actually done the exam, because it was so, he just scored off the charts, so they had to have a some guard be in there while he did the thing again, and then he proved that it was real. Of course, this is Rex's story, so we always are not quite sure if we're on stable ground or quicksand. And, you know, he wrote poetry. You know, you learn this from, like, his teacher, and he was promising with his writing, and he was really great with math. He was like a really whiz, like a math whiz, and he was working on a book to simplify math to your average layman, you know, because he felt like a lot of these math books are a little too esoteric. So, yeah, I mean, there's a lot of interesting stuff going on with Rex. Well, the glass castle was an idea for a house that Rex designed and planned to build, and, you know, it kind of infatuated his children with this dream of creating this incredible glass castle, solar-powered, beautiful place. And but it never really got past the blueprints, you know. And I think it could have been something that's extraordinary, but Rex was more of a dreamer than one who realizes those dreams. When I finally met him, I was really pleased. I think Destin is a phenomenal director. I really think he's of a just this class of directors that is kind of the, I guess you'd say, the new breed who are going to be running things. She has just a sense of confidence and a way of approaching a scene that I find refreshing, you know. She doesn't just settle for, oh, let's come in, here's my mark, here's my line, let me say that and go home, you know. She works hard and she's great at it.
Hey, Vale here. Now, hundreds of movies come out every year, but very few are hits. Here are America's top 5 highest grossing movies, adjusted for inflation, according to Box Office Mojo. Okay, number 1, Gone with the Wind. Released in 1939, is one of the world's first genuine blockbusters with a grand total of 1,786,074,500 dollars. Number two, Star Wars from 1977, the George Lucas space opera that launched 1,000 action figures and almost as many sequels and prequels, still reigns supreme in the Star Wars universe with a total take of 1,574,577,200 dollars. Number three, The Sound of Music from 1965, The Hills Are Alive, with the sound of 1,258,951,900 dollars in domestic ticket sales. Number four, E.T. the Extraterrestrial, the biggest movies of 1982, is also the fourth biggest movies of all time, with a grand total of 1,253,992,300 dollars. Number five, Titanic from 1997. James Cameron's award-winning film took in 1,197,594,300 dollars during its theatrical run. So, do you think that it's valid that these films made that much money? Let me know in the comments below. See ya!